When we talk about technology, people only think about mobile apps and internet. That is not the technology. For a company, like, especially for a manufacturing company, the backend technology is very, very important. If you look at idli, to get the best idli in the world, you need to get the best batter. Batter is the most important part to get the best idli. To get the best batter, you need to follow the traditional wheat grinding technology that our grandmothers used to follow at home, right? Which is using the stone grinding technology. You still see in some part of Mumbai, a traditional stone grinder will grind 3 kg of dal per hour. Today I grind around 25,000 kg of rice and dal per day. You can't imagine the number of grinders would be required. And moreover, it is not designed for hygiene reasons. You know what? Yeah. Whatever you try to do, you know, people will end up doing this. Right? You can't maintain it. You can't maintain the factory or, you know, end product with hygiene conditions. So that's when we thought we should innovate. And as we all know, within this confidential 500 community, as Rahul said, Raju said, most of the innovations in manufacturing happened in Germany. And unfortunately, Germans don't eat idli dosa. So we have no technology to copy from. So we have to create our own machineries. So we worked with a team in Germany. We didn't start from scratch. We used common sense. We identified a similar product, a mustard paste making machine, which was being used in US, designed by a team in Germany. We took that machine, got it customized to make idli batter. And today, with the press of a button, I'm able to clean the machine and grind 1,500 kg of rice and dal per hour, not 3 kg of rice and dal per hour. So that's how we invested in the backend innovation to scale up. So my piece of advice is, when we hear about technology, don't just focus on mobile apps and internet. Focus on the real technology, which is machinery.